dear traders, this is Petko Aleksandrov from EA Forex Academy, and today I will talk about the R squared, which we have as an improvement in EA Studio, and we have it as additional criteria to our trading strategies. So if I click on any strategy randomly in my collection, you will see that with the backtest output I have the R squared. And actually the backtest output, you can now change it and you can select which criterias to use from tools settings, and here are the backtest output metrics. So you can select which ones to see in your strategy editor. For example, the last one now at the moment is win-loss ratio, and if I change it to minimum count of trades and I go back to the strategy, you will see that I have here count of trades 333. So you can select now which backtest outputs to have over here. Now the R squared is a new parameter that is related with the equity line. So let me show you first what is R squared, and I will just Google R squared and I will go to images and I will show you what it is. Okay, so basically this is a regression line as a trend line, and we have different dots above and below. Some are on the line, some are not on the line. Here, for example, is another picture with many, many points, and there are many pictures over here. But we can say this is a regression line with different points above and below. So imagine we are having such a line here on our balance chart. So our equity line will go above and below, and then it will go above, and there will be some points that are on this regression line, right? And here R squared changes between 0 and 100. 0 is when our equity line doesn't touch this regression line. If it is 100, this means that all of the points are on the regression line, meaning that our balance chart should look like one straight line, and this would be the perfect line. But in our case in trading, okay, this will be if we have only two orders executed, right? So if we have two results, obviously we will see one straight line, and this will be R squared 100. So if we have more count of trades, obviously this is impossible. This is why if we are using, for example, the generator, let me switch to generator and I go to generator settings, and you see here in search best, we have now the option R squared. That's why it is good to combine it with common settings, minimum count of trades. It should be at least 10, right? To avoid having two count of trades for the tested period. Of course, bigger number is better. I normally keep it to 300 minimum count of trades. Now, having it in the reactor allows us to generate strategies that are having better and better equity lines. So the bigger number of R squared we have, the better equity line we will have, because it will be closer to this regression line. So here with this strategy, we have R squared of 77.35. Let me show you how strategies look when we are having bigger R squared. I will just bring from my next screen another reactor that I was running, and because I was using R squared as optimization combined with the out of sample, you can see here I have R squared of 95.99, 88.09, 89.16. So you see the difference between these equity lines and between this equity line. Here the equity line is getting much closer to such a regression line, but of course it is not a perfect line, which, as we said, it's possible only if we have 2 points or two orders when it comes to trading. So one more time, using R squared allows us to have better equity lines. Now, where you can use it in EA Studio, one thing is in generator settings, you have search best, and most common is to use it by net balance. There are different options, but now we have R squared as well. So no matter you are using out of sample or not, if you run the generator, it will look for strategies that are having better R squared, right? No matter what the R squared value is, okay? But if you want, for example, to have a predefined R square, you can set this from the common acceptance criteria. So I will click on it. The generator will use the common acceptance criteria. And when I go there, I will add it as an acceptance criteria. And I will add, for example, R squared minimum of 70. Okay, let me just go back now to the generator and I will press start. And you will see that it will generate the strategies that are having minimum 70 as a value for the R squared. Alright, and here is the first strategy. So you see the balance line is really stable. It looks nice. There are no huge stagnations. So the bigger the R squared is as well, we will have smaller stagnation. We will not have these huge drawn downs in the equity. And you can see the more the reactor works, the better strategies it shows, because in the generator settings, we have selected search best method to be R squared. Okay, so here, this strategy has R squared of 92.64, which is very good. The maximum stagnation is just 13.5%. We have a huge number of count of trades. All right, and if I click on edit, I will go to this strategy and you can have a look at the entry and the exit rules for this strategy. Okay, now the other thing what you can do to use the R squared is I will stop the generator and I will switch to reactor. Now, instead of having it search best by R squared, I can go back to net balance, which I said is most common because at the end of the day, we are looking for strategies that are bringing us more profit. That's why we want the generator to generate us strategies that are having most net balance. Okay. And now as a acceptance criteria here, I will remove the R squared, but I will increase the minimum net profit. Let's say I will increase it to 100, for example. And then I can use optimizer, which will actually optimize the strategies according to the R squared. Okay, so they will be generated as a search best method for net balance, and then they will be optimized according to R squared. And here you can select as well if the optimizer should use the common acceptance criteria that we have. Okay, so if I press on start, you will see I have generator, then the strategies from the generator are going to the optimizer. There is already one strategy, but I didn't clear the collection, so I cannot see which strategy was that. Let me see now the next strategy that will go into the collection. Here it is. You can see the strategy and another strategy coming up. So these strategies were generated according to the net profit and they were optimized according to the R squared. And once again, you can select this from the optimized strategy section where it says optimization. If you have selected, then the optimizer will work and the search best method will be according to R squared if you decide it. So one more time, as a conclusion, we can say that by using the R squared, we get strategies that are having better equity lines. We remove huge stagnations and we are able to generate strategies with better equity lines. Thank you very much for watching this video and let me know if you have any questions about the R squared or anything else about EA Studio. Always enjoy the trading. Cheers.